Let the to any I can pilot station to pick up the mail and bring it on through. Fly, fly, fly across the grave and the big blue sky's my home. I'll fly you up to now.
Well, and I left home in 1919, Warren, Pennsylvania. And I was going out to Tulsa, Oklahoma to make my fortune in the oil field. Because I come from oil country, you know, Pennsylvania. That's where they struck oil. And we got out there, and it was right after the war, and there was 5,000 soldiers came in on a freight train about the same day I got there. And they were discharged, First World War. And by golly, couldn't find any work, nothing, you know, and I'd get low on funds and didn't want to go home. So I enlisted in the Army, and they sent me to Oklahoma City, and then from there to Denver, from there to Cheyenne to Vancouver Barracks, Washington. And that's where I met up with a company I was going to be with. I didn't know we were coming to Alaska. In fact, none of the guys did. So we got to Vancouver, and we trained for about 2.5 months there. And then they said, you guys are going to Alaska. Oh, boy. So we got on. They herded us around like a bunch of, you know, they were afraid, you know, the guys were going to go over the hill, and they kept pretty good guard on everybody. And we got on board a ship called the City of Seattle, out of Seattle, and right up to Haines.
What was that ship like? Can you tell us?
Oh, it was a straight-sided ship, and it didn't have any, it had decks, but the decks were only about 4 foot wide walkaway, and then had staterooms off the deck. It wasn't a big ship, and afterwards I heard that it was sold down in Florida or somewhere, left the country. I never heard of it afterwards. Well, we got there to Haines, and we relieved the home guards, people from Alaska that volunteered, you know, or drafted. And this was about, I would say, 6 to 8 months after the war was over. And they were anxious to get home and get out of the Army, because the war was over. So they sent us up there, and we relieved them. They all left, went home. And the company that I was in was in Valdez. What they did, they took all the men in the 21st Regiment there and shipped them to Haines. And then as the companies went by, like Fort Gibbon, down Tanana, and Eagle, over at Egbert, I guess it is, Fort Egbert. Okay, as those different companies went by on the boat, why, they picked up the guys from Haines. So I was at Valdez. I was supposed to be with a company in Valdez, so when they come by, they pass us up, 20 of us, and we sit there for a while, and finally, my God, we got orders to go up, and we went up on the Alaska and went into Valdez, and I got there in August 1919, and I was there until May of 22. That was when I discharged. I came up to Fairbanks. I found out, I played a little baseball, and I found out they wanted some baseball players up here, so I wrote a letter, and sure enough, they sent me $100 to come up. So I came up here and played ball and basketball.
Let me stop you before.
I played the first game of basketball I was ever played out at the university with five of us, Earl Boylan and...
Before we get into basketball, let me ask you, how did you get from Valdez up here? What was the means of transportation?
Well,
describe the whole thing for us.
Okay, well, I got aboard the Alameda in Valdez, went around and up into Seward. I was going to get off at Seward and take the railroad. And I found out for $11 more I could stay on the Alameda and go right to Anchorage, which I did. And when I got to Anchorage, I had to spend the night there. You know, we got talking baseball and one thing or another, and I could have stayed there in Anchorage if I'd wanted to, but I wanted to come to Fairbanks. So I got aboard the train, and on the way, I can remember this distinctly, on the way, we had 300 passengers on that outfit, on the train, that the conductor said he would give the engineer a big kiss if he could get to Nenana without jumping the track. Well, at the train, those days, it wasn't ballast good, the track. You know what ballast is, that keeps the ties and everything from moving around. Well, we did. We jumped the track this side of Curry, Hurricane Gulch.
Okay.
Jumped the track. So they put 300 of us on a flat car, took us into Curry, and we spent the night there. And no, there were a few rooms, and most people laying on the floor, wherever they could, you know. And then the big feed in the morning, got aboard the train, went to Nenana, and at Nenana, we had to walk across the ice, and this was late May, and everybody was pretty worried about it, because this ice pool business, you know, and we had boards from the bank to the ice. You had to walk these boards and walk across the ice down the river. And there's a fish camp right there where we come out right today. There's a house there, and that's where we come off the ice, and you had to walk up boards there. Then we got aboard the narrow gauge, but got into Fairbanks about 9 o'clock at night. 900 of us, 300 of us.
What about baseball now? Tell me how you heard about the Fairbanks team, and what was it about Fairbanks that attracted you, say, over Anchorage?
Oh, I don't know. I just, this guy that I wrote to up here is from my hometown in Pennsylvania. And he knew the teams that I'd played with back there. So I went, no big deal. He sent me $100 right now. That was his own money, though. It wasn't city money. And then I got to work for the Independent Lumber Company for a while, and then a Sampson. About 3 years at the Sampson, and I learned to weld. Worked for the FE company in 1925. And all this time that I was working over at the Sampson, first I did work on Wilkins airplanes. That's where I got started in the aviation business.
So you first picked up the welding over at Sampson.
Sampson, yeah. I never heard of it, you know.
What made you decide on that?
Well, it just fell into the easy. I learned it easy. Well, it wasn't easy either, but I learned it. And I watched a pretty good welder work. And picked up a lot of his knowledge, you know, the procedure and how you do it. And one thing led to another, and he quit over there, the guy that worked there, Charlie Peterson, he quit and bought Pioneer Hotel. So then I was doing all the welding, and then my first job, commercial job, believe it or not, was to weld an arm on a pan of a Model T Ford to braze it on. You know, the arms that held the engine in the car had a arm, and it was riveted on, and then you braze those rivets and around the deal, and that's my first commercial job. Yeah. Gibson, Tom Gibson. And then from there on out, by then I went fixing those airplanes and moonlighting at night and working out on the field.